And now with that challenge out of the way, I think we got the egg one completed. We're gonna go and do the power hour. April showers bring May flowers, but beating the power hour challenge will bring 50,000 coins and a hair pack. Expires April 2nd at 10 a.m. So let's go ahead and do this here. And it is one, and it is worth 50,000 coins here. It is the top of the first inning, and your right wing is zooming down center ice. You need to hit this game-winning basket to be the curling champion. Win and be rewarded 50,000 coins in a hair pack that contains a 92 hair elite player auctionable. All right. I'm not sure if this is going to be hockey. Or basketball, or what have you. Mm-hmm. That would be interesting. My squad, England's got him by two. Two speed. But not in the other stats, but he does have more speed. And 94 speed to the Yankees. Here we go. And, as I thought, this is arcade. I have no idea how ridiculous this is going to get. Yeah. And, start with the safeties first. So if I was going up, let's go over here. Quarterback, and then, safety, strong safety. It's Taylor in Houston. That is Dawkins, and that is Kukli, and that is Singletary. I'm not sure if linebackers can get away with not being clutch. Their stats are also not nerfed. That makes sense. Like, if you felt like somebody was 99 speed, but they weren't running as fast and without clutch, and you're like, they got nerfed out there to think that means they probably were nerfed. That's totally gross.
This game is still mental, still psychological. Yeah, we just saw a big time run right there. But you have to believe he was dreaming about this last night in his hotel room before this one. Thinking, hey, every time I touch it, he's getting some good yardage in seven time. That's exactly what he got done.
And he takes it across midfield to the 45.
See his speed of getting up.
Some options on second and short. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
So this brings up a second and two. They'll set up to throw.
This is arcade mode.
Three successful plays in
true, because they haven't played that long a game in.
Taking in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field.
Damn string.
Well, I kind of want to play baseball, but given the weekend, maybe that I'm not doing good. And given the fact that I threw a two-hitter, I'm going to lose him. He's doing something here for a two-hitter. I haven't even started my 25 games yet. I don't have to do homework today, but I'm actually probably going to post it in both. See, Fuller came up there. Yeah, I might not even be done in the second fourth quarter.
That's just nice. 6 feet.
But he hasn't had no route knows to him. It's like 85, 89. This game is going to be pretty long soon. Man, if this was on NFL Replay, we're going to have 500 yards rushing. Yeah, give me a chance to run some of the rest of the book. So we have 15 minutes of football left to go in this game.
So two plays on that scoring drive. That's
Man, this is NFL replay. Or knock this whole thing out. Yeah, play action post shot. Okay, this is too far to see. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he just threw it in the Teflon and got away.
Charles, on third and goal for the 2 or 3 in that area, what do you dial up? Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something to develop slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football, if you're going to throw it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. A great play there. With a second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Rams add on to their lead. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him. And I'm liking what I'm seeing from those big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times we talk about low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the head.
That's recognized. That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take him out to dinner.
The drive simply that time, 5 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown.
Hey, nacho chips. I think those are nacho chips.
one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play
for a big shot
downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive, you're not. And last time I looked, it's still a first half.
See, Cooper's right there.
But you also don't have to be able to force everything either. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
So I'm like,
you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times, watch him make checks. Just like a quarterback would on offense to get him into the right defense. But definitely one on that play. How about that finish?
I don't know if I want to come over here.
Given 40 on the punt there, now they're looking at a third and about five.
That's pretty good.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They stacked him up pretty well, but when you try to run the football, somebody's going to play a long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs are not working now. They turn to 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
He loses 4, and it brings up 4.
I'll have to look at their stats. Let's see
if he does that
when you're 97 players.
This
book does not throw.
He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of 5, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Well, certainly some teams are not intimidated by down and distance on defense, are they? 3rd and very long? Let's go get this guy again.
Yeah, I think I am. I'm going to start throwing not higher than him. That makes sense. It takes more speed on the right side.
The completion good for 3 and second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tap them, they go down on the spot. Because if you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage.
And that's what Clutch does in
the offensive position where every series, they have to work hard.
They can make their own impact.
And you have to stall them out when you do that. Then we have to go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they got to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through.
The Roman Alice wins. Check for the catch left side. how you increase your batting rate, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you don't think that I can hear about that from him soon.
Now he'll take this for about 4 to 46 yard end. Tough run in there. That's a hard yard and 4 yards.
Yeah, those are doing some kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Second down, Ryan Matthews. And he'll find his way forward to about the 48-yard line. 2 yards to gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for first.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have control all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature in which you don't get ready.
Yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. We've seen quite a bit of a short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you go a short game until they stop it. If they're not going to stop, you keep throwing it, and usually you make the tackle and turn into a bigger game. So that's not a cool thing. Start to pressure receivers. Now you go out of the top, take it deep.
How
do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit, and find our way back into this game.
They can muster only a yard there. They'll be left with a third and very short. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just playing on the offensive side, is it? The defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was, and making sure they didn't get that.
And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction.
Luke Kuechly combines speed, intelligence, toughness, puts it all together. It makes plays like one we just saw there. It may not be a big-time blitzer, but boy, he knows how to pursue straight ahead and make plays in the run game.
Well, it's out of bounds, and we'll see what the side judge says. He says out of the 8-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they're not sure that they don't have to pump the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not planning to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're planning to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
Oh,
right. A tough starting field position here.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
On second down, here's Wilson, being chased on the left. Yeah, able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 7 there in the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Third and 2, now Wilson. Line time to his left. He can run for it, and he will. 4 yards, and he's going to run out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first.
You and I both know most coaches are really fearful about their quarterbacks running with the ball. They don't want him to take that big hit. I don't think they're worried about that with Russell Wilson. He's so smart in what he does, and we just saw it there in that scramble.
Yards.
How about that play, please, my brother?
we'll get Super Bowl come July. And then at this time, a little bit better than a partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive, they went 3 and out.
Now, play fake here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
But it certainly didn't waste any time throwing some deep passes here. And the defense, it was unexpected. They told their secondary, be ready, you're going to be tested all night by this team.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Sliding out of the pocket. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he will score. Touchdown. Russell Wilson. 37 yards. And the Rams add on to their lead. And maybe the defense.
This is a good chance for me to find out which thing is this. Look how you get. It's not the strong one.
He's unaccounted for as a runner, and he turned it into a nice game. A very nice run, and it turns in to 6 points. Now Tucker to add the PAT. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Mm-hmm. They'll come up now with the clock showing 3 seconds to go here in the first. Some run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. And get nothing there. Stopped right at the line as that will bring us down to the end of this first quarter of play.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's really a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Not to play where it did
play. They're getting a 10 to start the drive on by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
He's one relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Wilson now off the bootleg, loading the pressure right. And he will score! Touchdown! Russell Wilson with his second touchdown in this first half. And the Rams just continue pulling on. But the defensive coverage was good, so good he just decided to make the play of his own and it worked out.
They often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
He's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. They had a short field, and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. Kick this one away, and off it goes. Paul Turner now to return. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. 15. A loss of the full 3 yards, and now a second down. When you put together the formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game. Across the 20 to the 22. They'll get 4 on second down, but it leaves them with 3rd and still 9 to go. On any running play that's called, they're always hoping it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you can do so many things anyway. You come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on the heels.
6 yards on the pickup, and it's going to make it 4th down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is now with his height, sitting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
You're saying cuckoo, cuckoo.
I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away how to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just goes right over the top of it because he can see everything. Sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quickly.
Right, you here on offense, Chris Johnson trots back out there. We're in the second quarter. They got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what you're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, trying to get in the ball here in this drive. Going down the middle, and it's complete. 15 yards through the air, the first down.
Let's see. Oh, I did the same thing. Yes!
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw.
They hit that crossing route really well. Excellent time. He puts it right on him, and he keeps running.
Yeah, turn it upfield for good yardage.
Technically, I guess
we
probably need one right here. Or one room. Because he's kind of fast at the end. He's nailed it. He's a conductor, and he could do it. Because I need two. I need to add 2 routes to think that means, but I think I need to add 2 routes versus a cover 3.
Tight ends in
Dawkins. Nope. Back to throw.
Tucker now for the extra point.